Hey everybody, my name is Nolan and welcome back to another Pixel Gun 3D video. And in today's video, they just released a new trader's van. It's like a musical themed trader's van. There's quite a few weapons in here, but I decided to buy the Killer Core because this weapon looks so cool. I really like music. I make music sometimes on my free time. I make the music that I use in my videos, like some of the music, I guess, that I use in my videos. So I just thought this weapon is really cool. I really like this theme. And I gotta say, this weapon's actually pretty good. And dare I say, it actually kind of takes skill to use. Yeah, this weapon, the more you hold it down, the more the bloom increases and it gets harder to aim. So if you have skill and you're good at like releasing, like tapping and releasing instead of holding down, you can get some pretty good gameplay out of it. So shout out to Farman Beguet, I don't know how you say your name, sorry. Javit, if that's how you say your name, Nexus, and Shibu, I don't know how to say your guys' names, I'm so sorry. Yeah, shout out to all those people, because they found the hidden word, or not really the hidden word, but they watched the video and found the keyword, so I'm giving them a shout out. Editing Nolan here. Also shout out to Kai, I'm sorry I forgot you. If you guys want to shout out in the next video, I had quite a few people interact last video, so I'm only going to do 3 people for the next video, but stick around and try and find that keyword. Also guys, if you find this video helpful or just enjoy, leave a like, consider subscribing, and try and make Pixel Gun content daily. Doesn't always happen though. But yeah, with all that being said, let's just jump into some matches. Okay, so I haven't actually used this weapon without modules yet, so I'm not even too sure if this weapon's any good without modules. But so here's what I mean. Like, so you can hold it down, and that's good for if you're close to people, because like then you don't have to worry about bloom, because you're right up and personal, you know, their body takes up like the entire crosshairs area. But when you're far away, what you kind of have to do is tap rapidly to try and keep the bloom down, and that's when it gets kind of difficult to use. But it can be pretty good because it does decent damage. So all you really need to do is be accurate and land your shots. So if you can do that, then you're pretty much going to get good gameplay. And as you can see, I'm absolutely like owning this lobby. I'm not first place yet. I'm first place now. Wow, that did not last. Second place did not last very long. But see, what I'm kind of doing is I'm rapidly tapping the fire button instead of holding it down. But I don't really need to be right there, because I'm actually pretty close. I'm just trying to show you guys what I mean. Like, if I'm close like this, I can easily hold it down and get kills. Also, guys, sorry if I sound a bit nasally today. My allergies are absolutely horrid today. I'm feeling good, but it's just my allergies. But yeah, I'm trying to like find a good example. Okay, so here, these guys are kind of far away. You're far away, so here's, I'm gonna use it on you. But see, like, if I just tap rapidly, then I do more damage and I get the kill. But for some reason, I can't stay in first place. Oh no, this guy's way too far ahead now. I'm gonna have to start getting a lot of kills. See, that would have been a good example to not have held down the trigger, but I did hold down the trigger, so I didn't get the kill there. Or I did get the kill, but not as quickly. Also, since this weapon has a really high fire rate, you're gonna run out of ammo pretty quick, especially without modules, because the damage is reduced quite a bit. So you really gotta be conservative with your ammo, and be sure to be accurate, so that way, you know, you're actually hitting your shots, getting kills. But man, this guy's just spamming Bs, and that's kinda hard to beat, you know? Bs give you a lot of points, and they home in, so it's like really easy to get kills. Wow, who just killed me? That was weird. Oh, it was the guy with the bees once more. Yeah, I haven't really, like, showcased that, like, rapid touch thingy, and it's really hard to do. You really gotta be, like, you really gotta have practice with it, and I don't know if it's something people really practice with, because usually they just spray. I mean, there's no reason to, like, rapidly tap the trigger. I mean, that's not really a game mechanic in Pixel Gun, is having to rapidly touch the trigger. But this weapon has damage reloading, so, like, when you reload, it does damage. And actually, it seems to do pretty good damage. If I can walk up here, reload, boom, I just did damage to them. Let's see if I can get a kill with it. Boom. Nope. I don't think I'm going to, but I'm sure I can kill this person with the actual gun itself. There we go. Alright, this match is over, so I'm going to go jump into another one. So what I'm going to try and do is stay in these closer range matches, because it is kind of a close range weapon because of that bloom. That's like the only downside to this weapon, in my opinion, is the bloom. Yeah, it expands super quick. You can see how big it is, and it actually, like, it does make it harder. I have aim assist on, which actually helps with this weapon. If you're going to use this weapon, I recommend using aim assist, because, yeah, like I said, it's just hard to hit people once the bloom gets pretty big. But yeah, that's really the only downside. Otherwise, this weapon's pretty good, I'd say that. I don't know, this weapon isn't, like, the best weapon. Like, it's not like Ronin. Ronin is obviously probably still the best special, but this weapon is still really good. I like it. But that's just because I have a personal bias with music-themed weapons. I like all music-themed weapons, so even Mr. DJ, I like that backup, and it's not that good. It's a freaking sandbox weapon, so what do you expect? But, I just already have a bias with music weapons, so I'm gonna be a bit skewed when it comes to this weapon, because I want it to be good, therefore it is good. But, I mean, it is. It's performing pretty well. I mean, I'm not first place, so it's not, like, the best weapon, but it's still good. But I would like to try and take first. I don't think that's gonna happen. Wow, that's taking a while to die. But this weapon does seem to be significantly not as good. That was weird grammar. Without modules. But as soon as I can put some modules up, I'll start doing better. That's what I'm trying to say. I cannot talk. Reload damage, dang it. I was trying to kill him with my reload. That would have been cool. I'm up to second now already. So first place, it's gotta be close. Oh, never mind. I just went down to third. Reload, dang it. I'm trying to kill people with the reload because I did it before I started recording. I was just testing out this weapon before I started recording. I was able to kill people with the reload. So I'm assuming that the reload damage is actually... Oh, crap, no! I don't want to... No, I'm sorry. That might kill him with bees. I don't know. This guy's trying to speak Spanish. I don't speak Spanish. I used to. But after a year of not doing it, I just forgot it all. Because I suck at speaking Spanish. I took it for 2 years, and I only took it because I had to. If I want to go out of state for college, I have to take 2 years of a foreign language, and I have the credits for it now, so technically I've taken it. But I mean, I'm doing good, guys. Second place is pretty good, right? So I'd say that this weapon is good. No Ronin by any means, but it is definitely still a good special weapon, and it's cool. I mean, come on, Ronin's cool, but is it really, like, a good-looking weapon? I mean, it looks like a freaking demon. This is like a piano. It's like a keyboard gun that shoots musical notes in a stream of rainbow lasers that does damage when it reloads, and it's called Killer Chord. So, I mean, that's so cool. That's so freaking cool. I'm about to take first, guys. I'm a grind in the last 10 seconds. I won't stop shooting until I take first. Come on, die! No, I gotta be so close. 3, 2, no, I'm not gonna get it! No! Dang it! Alright, I'm just gonna cope with some modules on. So I'm going with the energy modules because you get sticky mines with them, which do some extra damage. Alright guys, if you made it this far in the video, then congratulations. I'm going to give you the keyword. And it's gonna sound weird. It's gonna sound a little weird without context, but I'll give you the context. But the keyword is Boom Kitty. Alright, and here's why. Because this song called the Killer Chord, or not the song, wow, this gun called the Killer Chord reminds me of this game called Geometry Dash. I don't know if you guys know what that is. It's a pretty, pretty popular game where you just jump over spikes and stuff like that. But it's evolved so much, and it's a really fun, cool, aesthetically pleasing game now. And in that game, I used to play it quite a bit, and I made my own level. It was called Chord Slicer. And that's because there's a song by Boom Kitty called Chord Cutter, which is a pretty good song. And I made a really cool level out of it, out of the song, that did pretty well. It was pretty popular. And I was pretty proud of the level too. It's not like a professional level, it's just cool. The song was Chord Cutter, oh my gosh, by Boom Kitty. And yeah, then I made my level Chord Slicer, I think, which is similar to Killer Chord. So yeah, keyword is Boom Kitty because I like him. I liked that artist. I don't even know, like, what it is, DJ? I don't know. Doesn't matter though. You guys got the keyword. Go comment it. First 3 people to comment it will get a shout out. I deleted all the people who commented it last video. Not all of them, because I don't think people really cheated that much, but I didn't want people going down to the comments and trying to steal it from other people. I'm in first place, guys. I did it. I took first place. All I had to do was put modules on and to get a close range match. I didn't even join in the same time everyone else did. So, I mean, that's gotta speak for itself. And you know what? I just realized I don't even have... I have extra points on. Let me equip the ultimatum to turn extra points off, and we'll see if I can keep first place. I might instantly regret that and eat my words for for taking that extra points off, and I could only be winning literally just because of extra points, but I don't think so. I think that this weapon is definitely good enough to where I can take first place. I love this weapon. I literally just got the Terra Morphing Stone yesterday, which is what I was going to make a review on today. But let me guys know if you want to review that, because I want to review it, but I don't know if you guys want to see it. I want to do it. But yeah, I just made that comment yesterday when I got it. I was like, this weapon's probably my new favorite weapon. But this might be my new favorite weapon. I don't know. I'm so indecisive. I really like Golden Friend. I really like this one. I really like Terra Morphing Stone. There's so many cool weapons in this game. It's just hard to choose. Can you really have only one favorite? I don't know. I'm still managing to keep first place, guys. So I'd say that this weapon, it's good. If I can keep first place, then it's definitely worth getting. I haven't even used my... I used my mines right there, but that was like the only time I've used my mines this whole match, and I'm still able to get first place. And in case you're wondering, yes, the mines... Yeah, see, I got the reload kill there. I did it. As I was saying, yeah, the mines definitely do make a huge difference. Wow. Holy cow, I am shredding right here. Yeah, I am completely satisfied with this weapon. Sorry, my thing cut out right there, but I was saying that this weapon was 100% worth it for me. But, I mean, my gems definitely did take a hitting. I was up at 1,000, now I'm down to 639. So, I am losing gems. Among Us sucks. I am losing gems rapidly. I've been spending them quite a bit recently. I'm getting out of that saving phase. I do have quite a few gems saved up in my battle pass, luckily. I don't know. I don't collect my gems from certain things. I gotta get this guy with the mines because I'm not running out of ammo. But yeah, I've been saving my gems like in like clans and stuff like that, like where you have to collect them for completing challenges. I just haven't collected them. So because as you guys know, I've accidentally spent gems so many times. Like I accidentally upgraded my photon sniper to mythical one time. That's 1,200 gems just gone down the drain, which was sad. It was so depressing. I can't get any kills here. Wow. I don't know. But this is a really spammy lobby, so that's gonna be a difficult thing to work with. Can I kill you? You've gotta be so weak, bro. But yeah, yeah, as I was saying, you know, I just accidentally spend my gems, so I always try and save them as what weapon is he? Oh, he's using the new backup. It's part of that Terramorphing Stone set. I don't know what it is. The Super Portalius set thingy. I don't know. Something along those lines. Yeah, I don't think I'm gonna win this match. We got a lot of spammers. B spammers and stuff like that, but I'm definitely still doing good. Wow, I almost just killed myself with that reload because I set off a TNT thingy. Let me see if I can take at least third place. I wasn't there. There's back to third. That was absolutely horrible grammar. I'm sorry. I can't. You guys know I suck at commentating. It's something that will probably never change in me. Even though I've been doing YouTube now for around 5 months, 4 to 5 months. I still suck at commentating. Just whatever you do, do not go back and watch my earlier videos because I had to cut through so much because I just could not talk. It was like my live streams. If you guys watch my live streams, you know that I don't really talk too much. I talk when I want to, but otherwise, you know, it's kind of awkward because I just sit there silently. That's basically what it used to be in my recording. You know, I just sit there and talk every like 10 seconds. But now when I make videos, I only have to cut a couple times, and that's usually just because I make a disgusting noise because of my allergies, which is what's happened this video, instead of just me awkwardly sitting there in silence while I play video games. But yeah, that's what it is in my live streams. That's why I like making videos more, because, you know, it's like I can talk about one thing, and then if I talk about it too much, then I'll just stop and wait until tomorrow to continue talking about it. I don't know, but then like in a live stream, I'll talk about something and then run out of stuff to talk about. But in like these 12-minute videos, I don't run out of stuff to talk about. I'm still talking about stuff, and I'm up to second. I haven't even been paying attention. That's pretty good. Up to second in a lobby with spammers like this, that's decent. And we actually have some good clan members from like Myst. You know, Myst is a pretty good clan. We got some good clan grinders. I'd say if this weapon's able to compete with good players like that, oh, Abyss, we got Abyss members too, then yeah, this weapon is definitely worth getting. Alright, so I'm going to wrap the video up here. I hope you guys enjoyed. Once more, if you did, leave a like. Consider subscribing. Don't forget to check out my Discord server and my clan down in the description. Also, let me guys know if you want to see me review the Terra Morphing Stone. I really want to, but I don't really know if I'll be able to review it before the time ends. But yeah, with all that being said, I'll just see you guys in the next video. Peace.